What is up, boys and girls? The Kingdom of Gains. It's your boy, Jacob the Hard Gainer Trainer, back once again to bring all of you another awesome video. In today's video, we're going to talk about the worst mistakes that you are making in the squats and the fixes for them. Before we get started, make sure you smash that subscribe button and hit the little bell next to it so that you know every time I put out an awesome video just like this one. The squat is a very important exercise for leg development, mainly in the quadriceps femoris and the gluteus maximus. The narrower the stance that you take, the more your quads are going to be targeted, and the wider the stance you take, the more your hips, more specifically your gluteus maximus, is going to come into play. The location of the bar on your shoulders will also affect the muscles that are targeted in the squat. A low bar position is going to target primarily more of the hips, whereas a high bar squat is gonna hit more of those quadriceps femoris and get you them quadsicles that you all have been looking for. If you're a girl, I recommend a wider stance to hit them glutes and get that booty. Today, we're gonna be primarily talking about the high bar squat. Now, how do you do the high bar squat? We wanna make sure that the bar is set high on the shoulders. Then we wanna make sure our feet are shoulder width apart or wider if you want to bring more of the hips into the equation. If you are going to use the high bar squat, you're probably looking for more quad development, so shoulder width will be enough. We wanna make sure that our elbows are tucked underneath the bar. We're first disengaging at the hips, allowing them to push backwards. Then our knees will come into play. Our knees will move forward, making sure that they're following the path of the big toe. The hips will drop and the knees will move forward until we reach depth. Depth can be considered when the femur is parallel to the floor or lower if you want to get the most out of the range of motion. Which brings us to mistake number one, not reaching full depth in the squat. Now, if you're squatting partial range of motion to develop explosive power or working on different segments of your squat, then by all means, continue to use partial range of motion. However, if you're using partial range of motion because that's how you think that you squat, I'm sorry, you're very wrong. Now, please put the 1245 plates back and stop bragging about your 405 squat, you half rep junkie. To find out if you need to throat jab your ego, try these three tests. One, have a partner tell you when you've reached depth. Two, video yourself from a good angle to see if you're reaching that parallel or lower depth. Three, find a box that is about 1 inch below your knee will be sufficient enough to help you reach that depth in the squat where your femurs are parallel to the floor. Continue to use these three consistently till you are reaching depth all the time. Now, you may find that when you try and reach depth, your heels come off the floor, which brings us to mistake number two, the heels lifting off the ground as we try to reach depth. In this instance, your tight calves are the things that are holding you back from reaching that depth in your squat. More specifically, your ankle dorsal flexion. First, what we can do is place plates or use weightlifting shoes to decrease the angle at which our ankles go into dorsal flexion. However, a quick fix is not going to suffice if you want longevity within your own training. So I recommend one of these three calf stretches to get you into that ankle dorsal flexion. First up, we've got toes on the wall. This is a simple stretch that you can do at home. Just place the ball of your foot against the wall, keeping the front leg straight and leaning further and further into that wall. The second stretch that we can do is with the ball of our foot up on a step or elevated platform, trying to push that heel into the ground, keeping the leg straight. Same thing here, we're gonna step through, leaning into that stretch, trying to feel it through the calf. The third stretch, which has become one of my recent favorites, is the loaded ankle dorsal flexion stretch. This is a simple stretch. We simply assume the lunge position, placing a weight on top of our knee and leaning forward into that ankle dorsal flexion to where the heel comes off the ground. This is where you're gonna wanna try and push that heel towards the ground and feel the stretch throughout your calf. Now, once you've reached depth, you may find that you're having a hard time keeping your knees out as you're coming out of the squat. This brings us to mistake number three. The knees cave in as we try to come out of the squat. This most commonly occurs because we have weak hip abductors, more specifically the gluteus medius. The two ways that we can fix this are, one, we can feed the stimulus. In feeding the stimulus, we're teaching our bodies how to resist our knees caving in. Using a banded knee squat, we're feeding the stimulus stimulus of our knees caving in as we come out of the squat. Now, when we feed a stimulus such as the knees caving in with a band, our bodies will naturally push the knees out to resist that very stimulus. It can also give you a very good cue on keeping the knees out and keeping tension on that band. The second way that we can fix this is by strengthening our hip abductors by using banded side steps. This is one of my favorites, and I highly recommend it even if you don't have weak hip abductors. Many people could benefit from this very exercise because we don't use very many lateral movements within our own training. Finally, we reach the final mistake. Mistake number 4, hip shift. The ever elusive hip shift. Hip shift is basically when we shift to our more dominant side or we're shifting away from an injury. Now, there can be many other reasons as to why this happened. However, those first two are probably the most common when it comes to hip shift. Now, two ways to fix this. Number one, we can, of course, feed the stimulus by placing a band around our waist, attaching it to something stable and having the tension of that band pulling us to the side that we shift to. Our bodies will naturally resist the stimulus, and you find that when you take off the band, you'll be squatting more in that middle ground. The second thing that we can do is use unilateral exercises to bring up that weak leg. My favorite for unilateral exercises in developing that strength is the Bulgarian split squat. This is a simple exercise. All we're gonna do is elevate the back foot with a box or a step that's 6 inches or above that. I wouldn't go above 20 inches. That's a little excessive. Then what we're gonna do is we're going to bend forward at the front leg, making sure that the knee stays behind the toe and that the heel maintains contact with the floor on that front foot. Also, make sure that your knee is tracking with the big toe and it's not caving in or pushing too far out. These will burn your legs up, they'll develop those glutes, and they'll also develop those quads and set you on the right path to having a perfect squat. So that is all of our mistakes. I hope you guys enjoyed the video. Yes, let's review. So mistake number 1 is not using full range of motion. Remember, try and get that full range of motion. If you're not using full range of motion, you're not getting the full benefits out of the exercise. Mistake number 2 is the heels coming off the floor. This is a tightness in your calves. Remember, ankle dorsal flexion is very important when it comes to the high bar squat. So make sure you stretch out them calves, maybe invest in some weightlifting shoes, or simply just place plates underneath your heels. Mistake number 3, the knees caving in. Remember, weak hip abductors will almost always guarantee your knees caving in. So always keep that mental cue to keep your knees out. Use the banded squat to feed the stimulus and create that body's pattern to resist it. Second, make sure that you're strengthening those hip abductors, more specifically the gluteus medius, using the banded sidestep. Mistake number 4, hip shift in the squat. You're shifting to that dominant side or you're shifting away from an injury. Use the banded squat, pulling you in the direction of the hip that you are shifting to or the leg that you are shifting to, and always use unilateral exercises to bring up that weak leg. That's the end of the video, guys. I hope you enjoyed. Subscribe, like, comment. Please let me know what you think. Ask me any questions that you may have. And stay tuned. Make sure when you do subscribe that you hit that little bell next to the subscribe button so you're notified whenever I put out awesome knowledge like this. I hope you guys enjoyed the video. I will see you all next time.